More croquet in the desert, east of Los Angeles. If you need orientation, look at the previous video in this playlist, which has a Google Earth fly-in. This is the United States Croquet Association, U.S. Rules National Championship, December 2022. It's being held at the Mission Hills Country Club in Rancho Mirage, a suburb of Palm Springs. That first set of courts there is their dedicated croquet facility, and then for bigger tournaments they can convert the four grass tennis courts in that unmarked patch at the top to have eight for national championships, the McRobb Solomon Cup, etc. Rich Curtis is the on-site tournament director. I think Jeff Sue set up the player pairings initially. I'm not sure they had a designated tournament manager, but I'm going to give Nick Gray that title because he was helpful to me, along with Donna Dixon, in finding accommodations for your videographer, Brian Hovis, who also captured this drone footage. Mission Hills has a lot of tennis courts, and you'll hear tennis balls thumping throughout. City of Palm Springs is at the base of the San Jacinto Mountains there to the west. We are the YouTube channel of the United States Croquet Association, which of course provides sponsorship. All things croquet at the USCA. And we're very grateful to Chris Barley for his sponsorship that allows us to do additional games at a big event like this. It's Thursday morning, block play's largely done. Now we're starting the knockout phase. We have two double life brackets of eight players each. This game features Sherif Abdelwahab at -3.5, who won his block, taking on Peter Bach at a handicap of -0.5, who got in by finishing fifth in his block and earned the right to play Sherif. Lucky boy. And here's what you have to look at when you pick your head up from your toils on the croquet lawn. We're going to be on court four, which is the one nearest the camera there. Peter Bach won the toss. He's been a solid player in AC and American rules for a long time. And he did just make it in. He finished fifth in his block, beating out Danny Honeycutt on net hoops. Sherif Abdelwahab is well known to this audience, has more national championships than I can count. He was undefeated in block play, pegging out in six of his seven games and getting 24 points in the seventh. He is on a roll, to say the least. I count both of these guys as great friends. Sherif's been very helpful over the years and was part of the inspiration for starting this video activity. Peter's a commercial freight pilot who sends Facebook posts from all over the world, and he's a talented woodworker as well.
1 minute.
And he is aiming at that flag.
Match time. Court three.
That was incredibly impressive, but you have to wonder why he did it. In AC, it makes sense. American rules, you knew that ball was going out. Maybe just to prove to Peter that he won't be able to hide.
Sherif, I want my money back. What? Shit, you can't take my money and have me play this shit, man.
Oh,
you coached me. I didn't even use your jump shot. That's
what I Stuart Price from Tulsa, being his usual ebullient self, and very supportive of our sport and this channel, by the way. I know you're tired of my saying this, but look at this lovely straight-up stop-shot hoop approach. This is the way it should be done. I promise not to say it again. Well, not in this video, anyway.
Thank you.
No. It's not.
Bad boy Mick Mihas was the vocal proponent of the out game back in the 90s, and I think Sherif actually won his first golf croquet doubles championship playing with Mihas. He thrives on the out game as well. Sherif is pretty adept at running two ball breaks. So if he hits blue on this shot, they're right in front of hoop five and he's on for the races. If he misses, he puts the burden on Peter, who can't just go set up. He has to either run away or use red, and it may end up in a wiring situation if he's not careful, since there are no other balls in the game. So not a lot to lose here. Best reason I know of for using a round mallet head. Now I realize what he was thinking when he shot it blue the first time. He is adept at two-ball breaks, but since black's not in the game, he can set a three-ball break for yellow with impunity. And with a three-ball break by Sherif looming, Peter has no choice but to try to stop it. Here comes evidence of the importance of the mental aspect of this game. He hit a shot from corner one to hoop three, which is 105 feet. How can that same athlete miss a shot that's about 20 feet? He's playing for the cut rush to hoop three here. But at least there's no deadness.
Play out turn. So that play out turn.
Brian appropriately intervened when Sherif tried to play yellow two turns in a row. There's no fault involved. Blue played and now it's red to play.
Blue to play.
No? Hey, did you make a knockout? How'd you do in third? Yeah? That's good. Because you didn't ring into it.
Yeah. We both made a mistake in the minors, the winner's bracket. It cost us.
Oh! Who won? Doubles.
With red and yellow both for hoop five, corner one is a good place to mount that approach. Plus, if Peter tries to take on hoop two with black, Sherif can attack there too from corner one.
Is there going to be a plate?
I don't know.
I don't pretend to know what Sharif's thinking, but now he's in corner two with both balls, which prevents Peter from approaching hoop two. But there's no problem attacking hoop five if blue messes up there.
Yellow to play, Sharif. No, it's they're all
yellow to play.
This is kind of the reverse of playing chicken.
red on black.
Is that good?
Red has a rush on yellow into corner three. Another corner might have been better.
World.
Wants to leave yellow as a pioneer for red at hoop six and get wired from blue behind the hoop. Interesting. This may seem a little aggressive. If he misses, he gives up a four ball break, but Sherif already has a three ball break. And at this level, there's not that much difference. Missing never crossed his mind.
Big shot for Randy.
Keep going.
I'll put yellow back for you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
What time is the flight? Yeah, finish up. It's fine. Peter, I'm going to send one down, all right?
Okay. Nope. Ooh, tough angled hoop to tie it up. That was harder than he made it look. As you can tell, we're not far from the Palm Springs Airport. Black is for Hoob too, so he's obviously working on his leave. Might be taking yellow over to Hoob too after he makes four back.
Thank you, Danny.
Just relax.
Despite the reaction, not too bad. He was down by three, now he's up by two with no deadness. But no recognizable leave either. Danny's comment was his shooter's broken. The board will catch up in a bit. Red's dead on black. Black is dead on blue.
Oh, gosh.
that ball.
To help you and me, column 6 is points scored.
Makes black clean.
It's got water in it.
So you're retired now, right?
I am. Luck lit?
Black already played.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I will mention it again. It was Sherif who beat into me that the proper approach to an odd-numbered hoop is a driver a stop shot because you get better rushes after you make the hoop. I've never seen him overroll one like that before.
Blue's clean.
Yep.
No, is the board right?
I assume the board only shows okay. Red dead on yellow. Red then set a rush for yellow to that blue ball, and I'm sure Peter considered running away with black, but he decided to let Sherif show him what he's got. Red's for one back, then on yellow, and yellow is for five and clean.
It's hard to believe this thing will break left.
I doubt he planned for black to snuggle up to red like that. That's a golf croquet term. But he's sure going to take advantage of it.
Lemonade out of lemon.
This game is so much fun.
Watch out, Sherif. Sherif, can you put that yellow stripe back?
I know you already figured this out, but black's going back there for red to use to make one bang.
should guard this shot that Red's going to take.
Looks like he went and mapped out a wired position, then decided not to use it. This decision looks a little less obvious than the previous one to me because Sherif only has a two-ball break now. He gives up a three-ball break, it could make a difference. But must be a pretty good double, and execution trumps tactics again.
Can you look at it? I can't tell you what it is.
I just want to know,
am I in the...
Inbound.
Sorry.
I usually say incoming in that situation. I wonder if that's the pilot talking. Red's too close to black for him to set up blue in front of Rover.
Go get blue for yellow now.
Time out for Mark. Thank you.
One out.
245.
245. Thank you.
Blue's dead on yellow. you see Rick in there? He's put his blue foot down.
Put him in, Dick.
I don't see him.
Double bank timeout.
Oh, there he is. He's in the golf cart to the left of the
shelter.
Get his clip.
Okay, so red is in dead on black.
I'm out.
52.
52, thank you.
It's red to play. Red to play, Sherif.
Three, red to play.
We're still in a timeout. I think Sherif meant for this next little gesture to signify playing red, but Peter either didn't see it or didn't accept it as ending the timeout.
Time back in.
So he called it himself because he's ahead and he wants that clock running. I can't help myself. See, if he'd used a drive shot or a stop shot, Blue would have gone a lot farther, and he would have had a better chance of a rush to hoop six after he makes five. And while he's thinking, remember that rush that Sherif wanted to take with yellow on red into corner two? It's still there. This is the worst possible place he could put black. And Sherif can't believe it. Just like that Geico Halloween ad where the kids hid behind the chainsaws. And black is first ball in last turns. I think he's trying to make sure it's not a trap.
Sherif, not to interrupt you, you did hear game time, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Make sure. Peter come here. You can't give Sherif that, can't you? shoot. He could go anywhere but there. The only place he couldn't go.
And now, just a pioneer at two back that Blue's afraid to shoot at. And Red has a three ball break to win it. Last ball and last turn.
Red is dead on black.
Now he's thinking more clearly. When I asked him what he was thinking when he put black in corner two earlier, he said, "You do know that your IQ drops by 50% when you cross that string onto the court." That's the way you do it.
Game over.
Usually works better than that, though. 2-point
game. Man, the bookies took a beating on this one. Peter Bach knocked Sherif Abdelwahab into the loser's bracket by playing really well and taking advantage of considerable inconsistency on Sharif's part. Peter lost to Randy Cardo in the next round. They both went into the Second Life bracket where Peter lost, I think, to Rich Curtis. You're going to see more of Sherif from the loser's bracket.
If you're not familiar with croquetscores.com, it gives you the whole layout of the brackets and the results. Thanks again to the USCA and to Chris Barley for their sponsorship of our channel in this video series. So while we look at the mountains over Palm Springs, give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. There's 9 more games coming out over the next 10 days from the U.S. Rules National Championships 2022.